Hi students, how are you all of you? You are watching here T.S. Eliot. T.S. Eliot, jiska pura naam hai, Thomas Stearns Eliot, he was born in United States and became a naturalized British subject in 1927. His early publications were, you must have read in your B.A., Proofrock and Other Observations, that is a collection of poems of 1917. Then Ara Vos Prek. Ara Vos Prek. This is of 1919. And there was a collection of poems only known as poems of 1920. Eliot studied philosophy at Harvard University and also received a lot of instructions in Sanskrit and Indian philosophy, spending a year in the mazes of Patanjali's metaphysics. He received a lot of instructions in Sanskrit and even Indian philology, spending a year in the mazes of Patanjali's metaphysics, which left him in a state of enlightened mystification. Agar hum short mein kahein, so he was actually a classicist in literature, a royalist in politics, and Anglo-Catholic in religion. In 1927, Eliot joined the Anglican Church and in the same year wrote the moving religious poem Journey of the Magi. That is a religious poem. His skill as a verse dramatist is expressed and beautifully taken into account in his Sweeney Agnostis, 1932, then Ash Wednesday and Marina, that is of 1930. If we talk about Ash Wednesday, we find Eliot turning to the Catholic faith. And though the verse of the poem is displeasing, Eliot had at least found a spirit to lighten his darkness. A more definitely Anglo-Catholic idea lay behind his verse poem known as The Rock. The Rock. And the second is Murder in the Cathedral. Murder in the Cathedral of 1935. Clear? Balki main ye kahun agar ki ye aur bhi zyada advanced hai, uski ek drama hai, The Family Reunion, 1919, and a great poem which actually was inspired by so many things, very important for you students for the NET examination, that is Four Quartets. Four Quartets, 1944. Eliot was very much influenced by Bradley's philosophy, and Eliot's philosophical contemplation blended with the religious fervor are expressed in the poems which are a part of the Four Quartets, that is East Coker, The Dry Salvages, and Little Gidding. These all three were published in 1943 as Four Quartets. And the major theme of Eliot's was time, samay, experience, and also the possibilities of reconciliation. और यस फोर्थ पोएम कौन सी थी इसमें, फोर क्वार्टर्स में चार है ना, तो मैंने तीन बताई आपको, ईस्ट कोकर, ड्राई सैल्वेजेस, लिटिल गिडिंग, द फोर्थ वन बल्कि कलेक्शन में पहली बर्नट नॉटन, बी यू आर एन टी एन ओ आर टी ओ एन, बर्नट नॉटन हैज कॉन्फिडेंट वर्सेस विथ रिफ्लेक्शंस इन अ रोज गार्डन, ईस्ट कोकर वॉज द सॉमरसेट विलेज फ्रॉम विच हिज फैमिली हैज इमिग्रेटेड टू द यूएस एंड द पोएम ड्वेल्स इन द पास्ट. In the dry salvages, what is dry salvages? It is a group of rock islands off the coast of Massachusetts, where he deals with his own past in America. Eliot is too close for any certain estimates, and he was the major influence on his own generation. And that he has created a poetic revolution. The influence of Wasteland, a great epical poetry of the century, has been immense. No poet in his own lifetime has seen such a verbal monument of criticism over the work like the Wasteland. He is a great poet as well as a great critic. And like Matthew Arnold, he turned to tradition for what? For orderliness, and established new standards for criticism and made a revolution in the taste of his generation, both by his prose and by his verses. A great poet, T.S. Eliot, while writing himself, should write of his time, then only he can be a representative poet of his age. And thus, as we find Chaucer's prologue to the Canterbury Tales writing about the 14th century, Tennyson writing about his own Victorian age, Eliot's Wasteland expresses the mood of weariness, the mood of despair, the mood of disillusionment of the post-war Europe. And here, in this epical poem, the poet gives us a horrid picture of the despair-ridden humanity, thereby giving a sort of detached commentary on the disintegration of the post-war civilization. His poems, his poetic dramas, all deal with the condition of human souls. And this human soul is always in a state of anxiety and in a state of irredeemable crisis as far the socio-political situation is concerned. We are actually passing through a great crisis, and his Wasteland depicts irreconcilable conflicts of the human souls which emerge out of a life without belief. And he makes the reader aware not of the problems of modern life, but also of mankind as a whole, where the soul of the man itself is in horror and loneliness, anxiety, depression, despair, unless and until it is redeemed by faith, optimism, and courage. Eliot has a spiritual approach to life, which is rare in the 20th century dominated by science and materialism. And so he gives a horrible picture of the anxiety-ridden post-war state of his mind in his poem, The Wasteland. The mind of the human is compared to a wasteland. Hamara mind kya hai? It is like a wasteland, which is actually devoid of hope, optimism and faith. Na hamare paas aasha hai, na optimism hai, na bharosa hai. The poet surveys the desolate scene of the world with a searching gaze. Wo torch laga ke dekh raha hai, bhaiya kahan hai, kuch bhi to nahi hai. He relentlessly uncovers its baffling contrasts and looks in vain for a meaning where there is only a heap of broken images. If you have read the T.S. Eliot Wasteland, ye line aapko milegi wahan pe. A heap of broken images where the sun beats. And the dead tree gives no shelter. The cricket, no relief. Cricket matlab cricket nahi. Cricket is a machhar janwar hota hai. And the dead tree gives no shelter. The cricket, no relief. And the dry stone, no sound of water. So these two lines, beautiful lines by T.S. Eliot in the Wasteland, is actually giving you the picture of the desolateness, of the despair, of the anxiety, of the pessimism. I still remember few lines about his attitude, the same attitude which T.S. Eliot has expressed in his poem, The Hollow Man. And what are those lines? We are the hollow men. We are the stubbed men. Leaning together, the headpiece filled with straw. Eliot, in the section of the Wasteland, that is the Burial of the Dead, he emphasizes the inevitable dissolution. The sacred wisdom too has fallen on evil days, and it is shown by the introduction of the tarot pack of cards. आपने देखा होगा वेस्टलैंड में टैरेट पैक का एक एपिसोड है. यूज्ड फॉर्मरली फॉर डिविनेशन, डिवाइन, डिविनिटी से बना है. एंड नाउ फॉर द फॉर्च्यून टेलिंग, भाग्य बताने के लिए. द सेक्सुअल एक्ट विच हैड होली एसोसिएशंस इन द पास्ट हैज डीजेनरेटेड इनटू सेक्सुअल बोर्डम इन द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड विच हैज एक्चुअली बिकम मैकेनिकल एंड स्टराइल and breeding not life and fulfillment, but giving you disgust and unanswerable questions to the society. The unending monotony of the modern life is described in a beautiful passage of that of a taxi man, a taxi throbbing, waiting in the fire sermon. The modern lady typist in the section, the fire sermon, does not give any importance to chastity. And after the completion of the mechanical sex act for money, this is modern life. If you remember that those two important lines, which are sometimes or many times asked in the BA or the MA, reference to context in the examination. She smooths her hair with automatic hand and puts a record on the gramophone. So this scene is actually giving you the terrible insight into the modern Western civilization. And T.S. Eliot, in his section, A Game of Chess, presenting a rich neurotic lady who is obsessed with sex and anxiety. This rich neurotic lady, with her dry hair spread out in fiery points, is the symbol of loveless lust. So also her husband is obsessed with sex like Hamlet. The condition of the poor is also pitiable, where Lil, that is the character, L-I-L, suffers from the evil physical effects of abortion and also of contraceptives. The people here are anxiety ridden. Perhaps these psychological perversions of the moderns may be the reason which induced Professor F.R. Lewis. F.R. Lewis ka aapne naam suna hoga, to call A Game of Chess. Matlab uske poem ko padh karke F.R. Lewis jaisa professor apne ko rok nahi paaye aur unhone Game of Chess ko kya kaha? Ki it is what? It is neuroasthenic episode. N-E-U-R-A-S-T-H-E-N-I-C. Neuroasthenic episode. Fear, anxiety. What are these? These are the cardinal causes for importance in the modern world. The central conception of the Wasteland is sexual importance. which is used as a symbol for the spiritual malady of the modern world. The presence of the fertility nymphs is actually a nightmare to the casual lovers assembled on the banks of the River Thames. And what TV sees, hears is the rattle of bones, the chuckle spread from ear to ear, instead of life-giving music, which brings Ferdinand to Miranda. Yaad kariye, what Tiresias hears is, in the poem, the sound of horns and motors, which shall bring Sweeney to Mrs. Porter in the spring, heralding the promiscuous love affair. In Tiresias is represented the modern man, who is you and I. Though he is desirous for sex, he is powerless to act. The greed, the anxiety, the loveless lust are the main reasons for the modern state of man's impotency. And there is a section in this poem, What the Thunder Said. In this poem, we find Tiresias thirsting for the waters of feeling. And Tiresias finds, if you remember in the poem, here is no water but rock, only rock. Rock and no water and the sandy road. The physical, the spiritual aridity of the desert is presented with a terrifying intensity. Uski line, do line mujhe yaad hai. There is not even silence in the mountains, but dry sterile thunder without rain. There is not even solitude in the mountains, but sullen faces, a sneer and a snarl. And the frustrated women of the revolution, torn Europe, are presented by the lines in the poem, over endless plains, stumbling in cracked earth, ringed by the flat horizon only. And so, all the efforts of Tiresias to get solace, happiness, through the sex and religion end in miserable failures. What is required on the part of modern man is more than ethics and a complete self-surrender to faith in God. And it is true that skepticism in matters of belief and confusion in thought are the order of the day. The bewilderment